again, my friends. I was requested to lead a bit of Zen meditation, which I very much enjoy doing. And it's a very appropriate activity, I guess, for the times that we're living in, when this stuff is coming up and we need to just come back to our center and let things be and let things wash through us without reacting, without judging. So we're going to be very practical. I am going to explain a little bit what the technique is about, and then I will play this flute called shakuhachi that is traditionally an instrument of Zen, while you meditate for maybe about 10 minutes, maybe 12. So the idea is to put first the three foundations of any meditation, really. Any meditation needs to be built on three solid fundamental foundations. The first one is posture. In Zen meditation, this is the mudra or hand gesture that we use. We relax it there. You know, it's just a little call to attention, because, you know, if we start drooping immediately, the mudra will drop. It takes getting used to keeping this mudra, but it's eventually very comfortable and brings energy down into the breathing area, your lower dantian, our field of elixir. So this is a mudra. Your spine needs to be upright, beautifully upright, you know, not here, which is kind of the teenager posture, not here, which is the Schwarzenegger meditation, but just very relaxed. Ideally, your back of the head raises up, so if I pull my hair up, you see what happens? My spine elongates and my chin goes down, and my eyes literally naturally go about 45 degrees to the floor. In Zen meditation, we don't close our eyes. Now, you know, for this particular video, you have your own choice. You do as you feel, but I suggest you experiment with not closing your eyes, just relaxing them and looking down. But you want to cultivate a global vision. So if I'm looking in this direction, but I'm still seeing all around me, so I'm cultivating this very open vision. And why do we do that? In Zen meditation, we don't want to go into mystical states, visions, cosmic stuff, you know? Zen meditation is down to earth. Arrive here, in this moment, in this body, in this place, which we rarely do. We rarely arrive right here. Mind is always racing in front, or emotions are behind, and the body is doing its own thing. And these three elements, the heart, the mind, and the body, rarely, if ever for a lot of people, come into alignment. And so we keep our eyes very relaxed and very open, because we want to create a sensual soup of this moment. So all our senses are very open, and we are cultivating a momentness, awareness of all our senses, yes? So, shall we start? Choose your posture, sit. I will lead you for a moment, and then I'll start playing my flute, and that's when the meditation starts. I will also play the bell for the beginning and the ending of the session. Okay, so are you ready? You can, you know, later on, or daily if you want, you can fast forward this particular talk and just go straight to the meditation and do it every day, because the shakuhachi music, the flute music, will kind of lead you naturally into the state. You don't want to pay attention to the sound of the flute as opposed to everything else, right? Remember what I said, you want to open up your awareness. We're trying to do meditation, not concentration. In concentration, we're doing this. In meditation, we're doing this. We're opening up to whatever is here in this moment. Everything that our senses are perceiving in this moment, and just like breathing in and coming into our breath. So we have posture, second fundamental, relaxation, right? So once we find a posture, just go through your body with your internal awareness. Breathe out any tension. Make sure your shoulders are dropped, your forehead and your eyes and your jaw are relaxed. Anal muscles, check out the anal muscles. They should be relaxed. So this whole tube is open from the bottom to the top. And the third element is connection with your breathing. So now if you're actually sitting with me, do close your eyes for a moment and just feel these three elements. Feel that your posture is beautifully upright. Feel that your muscles are relaxing. Here we can use our breath consciously, bringing in life energy and releasing tension with the out-breath. And be very, very sensitive to the process of breathing. Each in-breath, a miracle of life. Each out-breath, a release. So take a few breaths and then we're going to start the meditation. if you had your eyes open, I mean closed, slowly open them. Move your muscles a bit. You can brush your hands, bring some heat, some life energy, and just relax your face and your eyes. And after the meditation, we bring the palms of our hands together in heart center and just do a bow. About to this moment. So that was 12 minutes. 12 minutes is just enough if you do this every day. And if you do it every day with the same video, you'll get used to the rhythm of the shakuhachi, of the flute, and eventually you can just let it be. Don't really pay attention to it. It's just part of the environment, and it's a call. It's a call for you to keep going within and keep on breathing. What we do in Zen, when we find ourselves lost in a train of thought, we notice that, we return. Return to the body, return to the breath. And in that way, we train ourselves to be aware of the contents of our mind and of the nature, this cyclical, mechanical, conditioned nature of the mind, and we start gaining a little mastery over this thing we call my mind, which is not, if you think about it, quite yours. If it were ours, we could do whatever we want with it. Think about this, but it just does its own thing, right? A lot of students tell me how they actually think more when they meditate, but it's not the case. What's happening is that for the first time we're listening to the madness of the mind, and we slowly gain a way to disengage from that. Not stop it, not fight it, just disengage by re-engaging our attention to our body and our breath. At the beginning it may be difficult, but slowly it becomes a skill that we develop, and it brings amazing benefits to our daily life. So I hope this inspires you and helps you in these difficult times. Hasta luego, mis amigos.